Right. What's up, everybody?
Day 190, making Songbringer. Today I'm going to be making the Lightning Sword. Before I do that, just want to show off the Fire Sword. It turned out so good. It's definitely one of my favorite ones so far. And it's all better now. So yesterday it was a little bit overpowered, but now it's a little less powerful because you can hurt yourself on fire. It also doesn't last as long. So I think it's okay now. It's a pretty powerful sword. It's very tempting to get this sword. But I'll balance out the other swords to make it all cool eventually. So alright, so yeah, there's the fire sword. Now I'm gonna start working on the Yo, what's up, Eklof? Momir. Yeah, right. I love how that turned out. Let's go to another random area and see what it's like to fight some other enemies with it. Hey, what's up, Defend? Welcome, everybody. Happy Sunday. Might be Monday for some of you already. Let's go to, 0, 4. Yeah. How do you think it could be better? I agree. I was trying to work on that yesterday. I mean, it does a smooth exit and everything. Hello, what's up, Careful Moose and Jonah? Yo, you guys. Well, yeah, if you got any thoughts on how that could look even better, let me know. For now, I think it'll just have to stay how it is. Maybe if the flame gets smaller? Oh, I could do that. It wouldn't look that good, but wait, I could do a graphic. What's up, Ghost Saints? I could do a quick graphic. Yeah, let's do that. We'll do fire. Or fade it out. Oh, that's a good idea. I could try a fade out first. Because that's way faster. You're only a Padawan? We need like some belts or something like that. Yellow belt, red belt. Okay, here's where it starts fading out and flickering. It scales back. Yeah, here it goes. So we could go g.render.sprite.runaction. Fade out. Create. Fade duration. So if this doesn't look good, I'll actually do an animation that makes it look better. Nice, right on. We just have no belts. But do they have belts underneath their robes? Their cloaks? Okay, how was that? I thought it looked a lot better. It was a good suggestion. Some have belts on their hats. Very good point. What do you call that? Is that a hat belt? I've seen those. There's got to be a name for those. Yeah, I definitely think it looks better, too. Hey, what's up, Oxpita? Yeah, well, no, I didn't. I tried to get started a lot earlier today, but hat belt is going to suffice for now. I can also do an animation where this thing, actually gets smaller. Nice, right on. Cool. It definitely looked better, right? Let's do an animation that does makes it kind of die really quick. I mean, not die quickly, but do the animation quickly. So I'm going to go make this... there. Pixels smaller each direction. Maybe another pixel. Okay, now this one we'll do 1, 2, 3, 4. Now that was a little bit too much. The last one, we'll do like that. Maybe, yeah. Let's try that too. Let's see what that looks like without flickering real quick. The flickering was the very first effect I had in there. It was kind of gave you the feeling that it's about to die. You know, it's still kind of a video game, so I kind of want it to look like, but now that it's got all these other effects, it might look okay without the flicker or the blink. Yeah, I kind of missed the blink myself. I'm going to leave it in for a second. Let's see how it looks with that, with this better animation. One, two, three, four. Okay, now this last one. Actually, maybe one more frame. Hey, what's up, Long Shorts? Yeah, man, it's been a while. I hope you've been good, man. Hope things are good with you. Okay, one more frame, one more frame. 7. Yeah, super tiny. Okay, so it'll look something like this. The fire is dying! Okay, so I'm exporting these out to PNG files. We can use it as an animation when this thing's just about to die. Render. Go, we got fire die. I think, do I have a fire.txt? I do. There are 8 frames. No, just 7. It seems weird because I thought I added two frames. Oh well. Okay. Ah. All right on. Nice, man. Good. Good for you. Yeah, any way to get back into whatever you love doing sounds like good. An evil face? Okay. How about one of these frames, the first frame here? There you go, Alex Pita. Suggestion, reality. He does. It's an angry fire. Yeah, of course, man, of course. So we'll grab this animation. Right? So you suddenly have life. Someone takes it away from you. You'd be angry too. So we got profile. Get animation die. Well, let's call that release. I always name everything else release. So one thing I should do here is make this actually, if it's 7 frames long and the fade duration, oh, you know what? I could just go like this. Anim set delay per unit to be the fade duration over anim get is it total delay units? Something like that. I think that's it. All right, and what's wrong with this? Why is this giving me a warning? What local variable is that shadow? Oh, I already got fire. Okay. All I need to do is capture this variable here. Fire. Or I mean profile. What's up, Ghost Saints? Yeah, I'm a one-man team, man. I do the art, I make the programming, I do the code. I mean, I do the music. I do everything. Well, that's profile component. So we need Or is that a pointer? Thanks, man. Okay, let's check it out. I also make coffee. Oh, if only I did. What do I get? Dude, I gotta check out what the hell this profile is. Profile is new. Okay, that's what I thought. Profile. One of these is a pointer. There. Okay, well, if this works, then we'll have a fire that looks good as it fades out. And it's thanks, guys. Thanks for mentioning this, because these little details matter a lot, you know? Crash, no way. Fire Die 2 is missing. Fire Die 2 should be there. Let's check out what's up. We got sheets, common. It's not even there. What? Oh, 01. Oh, okay, so these are 0.01 seconds. That's why that animation messed up. Something's wrong there. It's true. In this case, the devil is literally in the detail. You know what that looked like? It looked like this fire was bigger or smaller than the other fire. So we got fire die here. Where's the other fire? Should be here in the same effects, probably. It's the same size. Yeah, you shouldn't be able to see the face very. But if I record it and play it back, you'll be able to see it. So what happened here? That's width 24, height 24. Fire die is 24 by 24. So what the heck is going on with that weirdness? All right, let's try, first of all, commenting out these other two actions. Man, it is a hot day here. I'm in Oakland, California, and it's like, I think it got above 100 today. That's like 40 degrees Celsius, I think. Okay, I think I see what's going on. What? Wait, it might be the other one. So Eid is the back one, which should be the regular fire. Here's the additive fire. Okay, this is gonna be a divide and conquer type thing. We'll get Eid 1. You know what? It's kind of silly to do that, because I can just capture Eids. Like this would be Eid 0. Eid He is zero. He is dot back. Well, I was just about to start the lightning sword, but now we've got a few little touches to make it even better without fades out. So yeah, I'll be starting the lightning sword here in a second. I'm just trying to figure out why this whole animation is getting kind of wonky. So I'm gonna do. I'm gonna divide and conquer by hiding sprites until I figure out what the heck is, which one is the one that's messing up here. As you what happens is when this runs, somehow there's getting to be two different flames when it fades out, and I'm just trying, because I know there's three different actual entities here that make up the fire and make it look good, so we'll figure out what it is. Nope, okay, it wasn't that one. Let's try the first one. Uptime! What's up, Azimuth? We're like, sorry I don't have uptime, but the actual uptime is only 20 minutes. What the heck? No, dude. It's gonna be cool. It's gonna be cool. It's just gotta be something obvious. So I've just hidden both of the other sprites. Is there anything? What could be causing this? Oh. There's that. Oh, here we go. What's up, PMC? This might be it right here. So this is where it creates the fire entity, and then it runs this action which repeats forever and calls animate, create, blah, 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 get the animation idle. So, which is a weird way to animate. I shouldn't be doing it that way. But anyways, I think what needs to happen here is this. g.render.sprite.stopAllActions. Yeah, it's all in C++, and the builds are really fast because I pre-built my whole game engine. I'm using the game engine called Cocos2DX, and I'm using a tool I wrote called RapidGame, which pre-builds like 400 different source files for me for multiple different platforms and architectures and configurations. So I never have to rebuild the game engine. So that's why it's so fast. Dude, it still didn't work. I'm starting to get pissed off. What? What the hell is causing that? Fire, fire, fire. These are good. That's fine. Fire. Fire. Die. You're good. Why? Where do you start? Game engine or no game engine? If it totally depends on you and your project, I would highly recommend starting with a game engine. If I were you, and especially if you're just getting started out with game development, don't write your own whole game engine, because it's, first of all, you're not used to using other game engines, so you don't really know what to create. And second of all, it takes a long time. So, but that only depends. Sometimes you really want to create your own game engine because you want to learn about game development. So that can be cool. So it all depends on you. I would recommend finding a game engine first and using it as opposed to writing one, though. Yeah, Azmaris, what's going wrong is that when this fire kicks in, it runs this release animation, right? And this release animation, it suddenly creates two different fire entities. So, these guys, there. So watch the fire. It'll suddenly turn into two different fires, and that's what's pissing me off. I don't know what's going on with that. Cool, thanks, Yog. Isn't that how wildfire behave? I guess it's a feature. Nope. Those enemy corpses have been there. Yep, every enemy in this game stays dead. So, yeah, you know what it might be? Let's put those back in. It might be the set delay per unit. Maybe that. Oh. I don't know. Yes, definitely. Good at game engines. There you go. There's your answer right there. Just ask yourself if you want to work on a game or a game engine. And if you want to work on a game engine, that's cool. That's a cool way to learn. But if you really want to make a game, don't focus on creating a game engine. Wait, did it work? No? Ah, what the? Does the fire light itself on fire? Maybe. No, I mean, it shouldn't. Watch this. If I turn that off, if I don't even do that, right? If I don't even get this animation. It could be a feature. TimeScar, what's up, man? Oh, cool. Dude, yeah, it's been a long time. I hope you've been good, dude. Are you still making a plane simulator? How'd that go? See what I mean? If I don't run this animation, it looks good. But if I try and run this new animation that I just created, it F's up. Cuddly Meth Head, yeah. It's not my intention for the fire to spread because that's going to get kind of complex. I just want to keep this to be a simple system for now. So that might be a cool thing to do eventually, though. But the reason I'm trying to keep things simple is because I only have 5 more months to finish this game, and there's so much left to do. Yo, what's up? Watch me make games. And Dekarki, what's up? I know it totally looks like the fire is pushing the other one to the side, but I don't know why or how it could be. Nice, cool, man. You're getting ready for uni. Sweet. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna hold off on this right now. Is the animation playing on the wrong coordinates? I don't know how it could be because it's not like I'm moving the sprite. All I did was play an animation. I've seen this kind of thing happen before when I had two different kinds. You know what? Let's do that. Let's go. I'll get the sprite's current frame. Okay. Auto rect R1 equals g.render.sprite.getSpriteFrame.getRect. Okay. And then we'll get this animation, right? And I'll get the last frame from it. So get sprite frame. No, kit. Get sprite frame. And then frame number -1 gives me the last, or 0, whatever. Doesn't matter which one. And then I'll go auto R2 equals this. Get rect. Okay, and I'll set a breakpoint. Right there. And we'll see what the heck is going on with this, because that could, it could be that it's trying to do that. No, nothing has a physics body in this game. It's all custom stuff with it, with an entity component system. So there's really no physics. I guess there is a technically there's a position component and there's a collision component, and both of those have 3D positions. But okay, let's see what's going on there. Hey, what's up, Liar Thief? Yes, totally careful, Moose. That's exactly what I'm checking out here. Oh, is there a collision between the fires? There shouldn't be. No, they're not two entities that actually would collide with each other. This is a really good question, right? It looks like there's a collision moving it, but let's see if it's that frame thing. Yeah, exactly. I think it might be what careful Moose is saying right there. So let's check out these two values, right? I got two rectangles. One of them is the existing rect for the sprite as it was, and this one here is the new rect. So, okay, no, R1, okay, R1, origin, size. There you go, that's the problem. The original size is 1, I don't know how. And the new size is, of course, going to be probably 24, or width 14, 16. Yeah, that's the problem. Okay. So why? Why is... Oh, check it out. Here's why. That's it. This is the big problem right here. The problem is that it's not starting with the fire. Oh, it has a child. Oh, I feel like an idiot. Okay, so here's what's going on. It's creating an entity, right, that holds this fire. And then for some reason, I wrote this code. I wrote this a long time ago. But I wrote this so that it would add a child. There might have been a reason why I had to do it this way. So, okay, all I got to do is get in here and find the child of this entity and then animate that thing. Okay, we found it. That was it. TimeScar, no, I don't actually use a standing desk per se. I'm actually inside a closet. This is a makeshift standing desk. I got my computer up here on the top shelf, and then I put my keyboard and like graphics tablet and everything down on this, like some boxes. So you don't have to actually buy a standing desk to effectively use to stand up and work. Yep. Dot Garek, do you remember that? Were you there when we wrote that? Right? Hey, what's up, Vlad? Yo, man. How you been, Vlad? Okay, so I gotta loop into this thing's children. I can get this animation. It's okay to set the delay per unit, probably. I don't need to do this code anymore to try and delete or whatever. Uncomment that for auto ref child in g.render.sprite.getChildren. Totally, right? Sweet. What's up? I'm finishing up this fire sword animation. It's pretty cool. You can see a screenshot right there. You shoot out this cool fire sword thing, and it lights up enemies and sets them on fire. It's kind of one of the sickest weapons so far. So that might be necessary right there. Okay, so here we go. So this is going to be the first child, so we can go child, run action, and then break. Really? I've never seen this one. Battle Stations. Ooh, that's a nice one. Cool. I'll do this later on tonight. Right, did that compile? Yo, what's up, Lime Studios? A class system for the items? No, because it's more like Zelda. So yeah, Sergeant Sir, that would be kind of appropriate for a Diablo-like game, but this is a Zelda-like game, so it's a bit different in how the items work. You can craft items though, so but no, there's not really a common, rare, epic, legendary. I guess if I were to kind of do that with this crafted item system, you would be able to take a certain item and then add on something which make it more epic. I don't know. I'm not sure how that would work, but okay, cross your fingers. I hope this works. Yeah. Oh, it worked. Right on. That was great to see. Let's turn off that fade so we can kind of get a feeling for what would it look like with just that animation. Yeah, my MacBook is a MacBook Pro from 2013. The specs on it are like, it's a 2013 model. The only upgrade I had. Yeah, Woot for sure. Yeah, those guys are throwing rocks. Yeah. Oh, okay. That was weird. It kind of came back in, but I think what we need to do is turn off. Turn off all actions first. So it just fades out. This should work though. We set a breakpoint here to figure out if that. Wait, let's do this. Auto units, so we can just check the debug value there. Nice, Grim Fandango! Oh, cool. Yeah, I played that back in the day a lot. I love that game. Yeah. Okay, so I've set a breakpoint here just to make sure this whole fade out is working, because it looked to me like the fire faded out and then came back and faded out again. Okay, so let's see, units. We got fade duration and units. Units is 7. Yeah, okay, units is correct. And then fade, why doesn't it have fade duration? Probably part, yeah, there it is. 1.1. Okay. Yeah, that should work. Delay per unit. Okay, that's good. What kind of tech jobs have I had? Yeah, man. Peace out. You leaving? See ya. I've worked for a music company back in the day. And I've also worked for a few different game development companies, but mostly I've had my own business. So for a while I had my own business software type business. Yay! It worked that time. And okay, we'll try it once more without the blink. Yeah. It definitely helps. It definitely helps. It helps my spine especially, but it also gives me more energy. And I don't have the energy to do it all day. I used to have the energy to do it all day, but lately I've kind of had weaker energy. I need to get my chi back up. Yeah, I kind of like it that way. Okay, I'm going to leave these commented out for now. Yeah, it's definitely looking pretty good, right? Do I try not to? Ziok, this is a great question. Do I try and keep my project organized? I try not to, but this is such a big, long project. I mean, this has already been 8-9 months I've been working on this, and I'm probably going to work on it for another year and a half. It'll actually get released in 5 months on Steam, but the way I'm kind of keeping organized is this ideas.txt file. This has a list of bugs. You can see I have like something around like 100 different bugs I need to fix already. And then I got this list of ideas I also need to work on. But yeah, I do plan to get to every single one of these. But right now I'm just trying to throw in all the features first. So there's way more items to create, more overworld art, a lot more dungeon art, more bosses to create, more enemies. And all those things are higher priority than fixing these bugs or adding in cool ideas. So you need more mana? Yes, I use Git. Yes, I did. I sketched it up. When I started working on this game all the way back in November of 2014, I was sketching things like crazy. So I started with some mock-ups, right? So where, I think I have this folder called Sketches. These were all my original sketches. These are so bad. This one? Look up, look at that. This is so old school. Where is it? That's a lot more recent. That's not it. Maybe it's in this other folder. I want to show you this one image that basically I finally settled on, and I was like, "That's it. That's what I want to." Look, that one's old too, as well. No, Cave Square. That's it. Here, finally. So I did so many different mock-up images. You saw me just going through a bunch of them there, but I finally settled on these characters that I liked, right? And this is when I finally drew Rock for the first time. And there's Vel, and there's Jib. And so I settled on this kind of look, and I was like, that's it. That's what gave me the idea for making all the art for the game and stuff. Hey, what's up, Taco? I know, yeah. Yeah, I kind of think it's better to add new features before you fix bugs, unless you have an upcoming release, right? When you get to the release stage, you want to polish things up, you've really got to finish it up and make sure there's no outstanding bugs. But if you have the time, it's better to add the new features because they are going to introduce new bugs themselves. Sketch folder included in the game. Azenris coming up with great ideas again. That might be cool for some people to see, right? Let me put that on the ideas. Sure, why not? They could see how far it came. Timescar, that's so funny you call me an artist, right? Because a year or two ago, I would definitely not have called myself an artist. I've recently become an artist, and these are all my advice on how to become an artist yourself. Here's how you can do sketches. Yeah, and you definitely don't need to be a good artist to do sketches, for sure. Okay, so let me check in this code and we can go start creating the lightning sword. This lightning sword, feel free to shout out ideas, especially as I'm just about to start this, because what I'm thinking is the lightning sword will be like the fire sword, except that it causes chain lightning. And I know you guys were saying on the stream the other day, you're like, hey, will the lightning sword do chain lightning? And I was saying, no, there's going to be a separate item for chain lightning. But I couldn't think of a better way to do the lightning sword than to do chain lightning, so if you guys can think of a cool idea for how to do the lightning sword, feel free to shout it out. Yeah, you saw that one, the swirl nut. There's so many great ideas on here. Polka music, evil grandma. Some of these are really easy ideas, like just naming the levels and stuff. Yeah, that's a great thing, great suggestion too. Pixel dailies. Nice. Wait, did I check that in? Hold on. Yep. Okay, cool. This is just, okay. Nice. Cool. I'm going to check this one out. I'd love to check out tutorials myself. I would consider my art my weakest skill in all of my game development. So I'm still learning myself. You could throw it like a boomerang. That's an idea. I mean, I already have the top hat for that though. Oh, you call down a lightning strike from above. Oh, no, that's cool. Yeah, Jonah19, same suggestion. Cool suggestions, you guys. I like that one. Teak, what's up, man? Are you asking me? No, I don't have time to participate in Ludum Dares myself. I literally spend 7 days a week coding this game, doing art for this game, just developing this game. So, and I've got to haul ass to finish this game on time in December, January, something like that. The lightning sword can create a force push effect to push swarms of enemies back. That's an interesting idea. Yeah. That's kind of what I was thinking for the Dekarki. That's kind of what I was thinking for the chain lightning item. I love this idea of a lightning bolt coming down from the sky, because that's pretty cool. Yeah, there could be. There definitely could be. There's already that effect is already working on the fire sword, but I could do it with the lightning sword too. Totally Highlander. Which Highlander movie is this? Is this 2, 3, 1? Yeah. This is worth watching. Again, and I think this is the first one, right? I love these like sort of hand-drawn 80s effects. I freaking love the 80s. Oh, and a curve. Oh, okay. Interesting. Yeah, it was a success. Do I recommend Kickstarter to others? Of course. Yes, I do. I'd recommend that you prepare a lot for your Kickstarter, though. And I'm gonna do an article on how to do a Kickstarter. I have it halfway finished, so that'll be up on my website at some point. But yeah, I definitely recommend a Kickstarter. You just need to prepare like crazy. And you have to have an existing following. You have to have built up enough of a following that you feel like your Kickstarter is able to achieve its goal. Oh, right, yeah. Wind sword could be. Nice. Right on, Takio. Good for you, man. That's cool. I like you that you settled on Unity. There's plenty of tutorials out there to learn with Unity. True, yeah. Listen to Lime Studios. Definitely don't use Unity script, JavaScript. Just use their C sharp and you'll be good to go. Okay, I'm trying to think of how we'll do this lightning effect. I'll start with drawing it. So it could be up to 240 pixels high, about. Let me get my pen and we'll just do this animation. We'll do it right. So yeah, I'm gonna go with this whole lightning striking down from the sky, and I can do a chain lightning effect for a different item, or you know what, I can, as long as I have the behavior done for either one of them, I can switch the effects if I want to later. So let's do this. Yes, definitely. Yeah. Nice. Yeah, totally. White flash. Oh, yeah. I'm thinking of the whole screen turning white for a second. For a very, very, like, quick second. Why not both lightning and the chain lightning? I mean, that could be, yeah, I guess that could be could be done, yeah. Yeah, definitely. Area damage. Yeah. Yeah, totally, right? Just that one quick frame, or three or four frames, something like that. With white light, it'll look pretty sweet, I'm sure. In fact, I could make it additive lighting even. I could try that with additive lighting. That might look really sick too. Yeah, definitely. I think I'm actually going to have to give everybody double the health right now. Like, it won't actually work out to be any different, but I only have two different health per heart right now, and that makes it really hard to do these kind of, like, less damage effects. So I'm probably going to have to change the range of health and stuff, but it'll all work out to be the same. What's the best advice I would give to myself in the past about game dev? TimeScar, I got you on this one. This is the best advice I think I can give anyone in general about everything in life, whatever you're going to do creatively. And that's to just do what you love and don't be afraid to do it. And don't be afraid to let people and the universe and everything help you do it. So for a long, long time, I was scared to do this game. Like, I was like, you know what? People are going to steal my ideas if I do a live stream. And I was like, people are going to steal my ideas if I share pictures daily. You know what I mean? I had all these fears. And also my biggest fear was that I wouldn't have enough money, because I didn't have any money coming in when I started this game. And I was like, there's no way I can make a game that will actually be financially successful. There's so many other great games out there. The market's saturated. I had all these freaking fears, right? And I'd say that my biggest advice would be to just get over your fears, however the heck you're going to do that. Get over your fears and do what you love. Do what excites you, because doing what excites you is like the shortcut. You know what I mean? You'll shortcut over all the BS that you don't really need to be doing. Nice, yeah. What's up, Nano? Yeah, you're beat. Yeah. It's a hot day here, too. I'm kind of beat. Yes, exactly. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking, too. Oh, whoa. Do it. You played the whole game? Wow, Nano. Good for you, man. So I'm doing this all in white to start with so I can color it in the code procedurally. Hey, what's up, Zelda Rock? It's going great, man. I'm making the lightning sword today. Wow. Oh, man. Yeah, that's how hot it's been here, too. Like, today it's over 100, which I think is 40, or around 40. Oh, man. Whoa. Shadow alter ego generated by rage that attacks you with the same weapon you have? Like the all... Oh, yeah. That's so Zelda too, but I love it. I love that idea, and it's really easy because you get to reuse your existing sprites. So I like it. Ah. Oh yeah, yeah. Yeah. Definitely, I love that idea. Cool, it's on the list. I was watching some Diablo videos today of their chain lightning to kind of get inspired for how to do lightning. So, I don't know, I kind of... Yeah, that's good enough to start. Whoa, yeah. Yeah, Altec Studio. That's where I'm at, too. I'm in California. 8 Celsius. Oh, man. Oh, New Orleans, cool. Yeah, Takio, we just posted some links about that a second ago here. Who posted that link just a second ago? Anyways, I gave some advice on how to create art. Here's my advice. But there's several other great pixel tutorials out there. Yeah, I know. It's so dry. Oh, you're in Santa Rosa? I'm in Oakland. Cool, man. That's great. I'm finally meeting people in California. Yeah, there you go. Oh, you're in Inland Empire? Like Inland Empire, Southern Cal? Or like Inland Empire? Oh. Yeah, you're SoCal for sure. I came from San Diego, so that's where my la we last resided. All right, cool. Here we got frame one. So I want to see like two, three, maybe four frames, something like that. Okay, next frame. Yeah. Germany, sweet. Yeah, I know we're so dry. You guys are even drier down in Southern California. Man, I remember, dude, we're getting so kind of critical, right? We need some water, big time. I like that little empty spot there. Yeah. Yeah, I love how the application files are stored in Unix or in OS X for sure. The thing I love the most though is that it's a Unix operating system. Just can't live without that. What do you guys think of Windows 10? I was thinking about upgrading, but I'm kind of okay with Windows 7. Yeah, this bottom part is looking too. Too. What's the word? Yeah, I'm on a Mac. I'm on a Mac, but I have boot camp, so I have a Windows partition, so I can boot to that if I need to. That's how I get the builds for Songbringer to be on Windows and all that. Okay, that's good. Frame two, done. You just duplicate this and blur it. All right, cool. We got two frames of lightning already. Nice, right on. Yeah. The force Windows updates? What are those? Does it actually force you to update Windows 10 all the time or something? Oh, lame. All right, Lime. See you, man. Yes, Atari. I highly recommend Game Maker for beginners, for sure. Yeah, Game Maker is great. Unity's great. All these kind of like software type game engines are good things to start with when you're a beginner. I highly recommend it. What? You can't untick updates? Oh, lame. Man, I might stick with Windows 7. Oh. How to make the lightning glow? Oh, yeah, let me show you. It's really easy. It's just Gaussian blur. So I took this layer, right? All I did is I drew some pixels, right? I just duplicated this layer, boom. So I'm working on a second layer that's a copy of it. So if I were to just show you that layer, it looks like this, and then I go filter, blur, Gaussian blur. It's a really simple thing. And I've got it at a radius of about 2.4 pixels, and you can see the result here. It's just a blurred out thing. And then if I turn on the original layer that I before the duplication, you got a pretty cool looking lightning effect. So that's all that is. What am I using for a library? I use Kogo 2DX. It's a great engine, but I think it's more for intermediate to advanced programmers, because you really got to do everything in C++. And it's an open source thing, so it's not like there's any soft. It's all code. There's no software that runs it, so it's a little bit more difficult. But I highly recommend it if you're a knowledgeable programmer that you already know C++. It's a great engine because it's cross platform and it's open source. And that's about it. All right, next one. I'm gonna do four layers total for this effect. Yeah, you're welcome, Timescar. Kind of like that one. Oh, wow. Yeah, I've never tried that. Yeah, totally. That's definitely one of the reasons why I recommend Game Maker is it's really easy to use. So that's what's so great about it for beginners. But it also teaches you to code because you're going to have to code a little bit. Yeah, that too. No, definitely not. Coco Studio X is cross-platform. It's for Windows, Mac, Linux. You can develop with it for all platforms. And not only can you do that, but you can publish to Windows, Mac, Linux, iOS, Android, Windows Phone, BlackBerry. Like, you can publish to so many platforms with it. Write my name sideways. All right. That's a cool idea. How do you know how many frames to make for a good animation? That's something you just get used to. And it all depends on your game and how many frames per tenth of a second or so you're going to be using. I kind of have settled on about a frame every tenth of a second. And then what I do is I make what I think is about right? I'm kind of used to it now, so I make about right, and then I play with the actual delay per frame sometimes in my animation. So for example, the fire animation has a delay of 0.0618 per frame, which makes it a little bit faster than a tenth. Yeah, 60 frames a second would be great, but that's so many frames. If you want to draw that many frames, that's a lot to draw. So that's like 60 frames a second. That's 6 frames every tenth of a second. So that's a lot of work, man. I'm at 10 frames per second, and it looks all right. It looks pretty good for pixel art. And in fact, sometimes I go to about 20 frames a second for art for some animations. And just to, especially if you want to make a certain animation a little more detailed. Yeah, sometimes they are. Or maybe 30. Will the game be locked at 24? No, the game is at 60 frames a second, in release mode. In debug mode, as you're watching me on the live stream, I could only do 30 frames a second because I've got Open Broadcaster running in the background. But yeah, the final game is 60 frames a second. And it just makes some things a bit more smooth. Metal Slug? Yeah, Metal Slug had some good animations. I don't know particularly how many frames each one of these games is really using in their animations, but it'd be a cool study. All you gotta do is film a little bit of the video, or a little video of it, and then kind of play it back and figure out how many frames they're using per animation. A really cool one to actually look at is Street Fighter. Because you get to know how many, like how to do these like cool blurring effects. They really do some cool stuff to blur their characters with the motion. In fact, there's an article I read about that. I have no idea where. I think I lost the link to it, but there's an article out there. It's a study of Street Fighter 2. And their animations. Yeah. Oh, PMC, you got to go back in time and play some of the greatest games ever, like Castlevania, Metroid, all of the Metroid games, the older Zelda games. Oh, there you go. Yeah, just look at the sprite sheet. Right? I forgot about that, Vlad. True. Damn. Dang, man. What's up, Grim Gary?
Shoryuken.
Yeah, who doesn't love Zelda? I don't know. There was somebody in the chat the other day that hadn't played Zelda. We were all like, "Yo, you gotta play Zelda." Okay, next frame. We got four. This is the fourth one. Okay, so we were thinking of drawing my name sideways. So, canvas rotate. How do I rotate the canvas? Does anybody know how to rotate the canvas? I could just rotate the whole image. Something I don't use enough of, rotating the canvas. I thought it was like a window. No, yeah, you won't be able to play games like that on the VGS. The VGS is meant to play new games. That's the big difference between it. You're tired, man. You should go to bed if you're super tired. Is that it? Oh, to Fen. No, this is not it. There was another one that was actually going into the actual motion blurring of it all. Like they really broke down Street Fighter 2 and showed like all these animations and the different techniques they use for motion blurring. But this looks like a good one too. Trex Mix. It might be on your end or it might be Twitch. Oh, it does look like I actually dropped some frames today. I don't know. It might actually be my fault. I don't know what's going on here. Could just be network issues or something. What's up, Alien? Yes, totally. Link to the Past, Super Metroid. Yeah. Yeah, to fend, this is actually to flip, this is actually flips the actual data. What I wanted to do is actually just rotate the canvas, but I know there's you can do that somewhere. Thanks, Trex. Yeah, I love the adventure games too. Oh. Yeah, that's the same thing. Yeah, I know I can flip it back, but there's actually a tool which you can use that just rotates your canvas and you don't actually have to change your data of your image and stuff. Oh, no way. Yeah. Where's the shorty? Oh, here it is. So awesome. Yeah, I'll just flip it back. Control T, is that it? No, not on Mac, I guess. Yeah, non-destructively, exactly. There's a something, but I'll just do it destructively. It doesn't really matter. What's this? Oh, rotate your canvas. Image rotate canvas? No. Edit? No. No, I know it has it. I know it has it. Yeah, screw it. I'm just gonna rotate it for now. Cause it's pixel art. It doesn't really matter. So I'll go clockwise. Okay, here we go. Yay, cool. Option spacebar is great, but that's just zooms. That's actually a really, really great shortcut to know, though. So the request was to draw my name sideways. All right, cool. That's kind of my name, right? And I'll make it some cool art. So go back. Hadouken! Echo! What's up, crazy man? Oh, right. Oh, yeah. Sorry. I never thought about that. Yeah. Let me do that again just to mess with you. Sorry. This is cool. I never would have thought of doing this, writing my name and with lightning, but it actually works. Note to people making their own art, you can write your name with lightning. All right, Jonah, good night, man. I'll try and get some earlier streams for y'all in this week coming up. Yeah, I get this every once in a while. I get Tony Stark, but what was the other one? Somebody said Pauly Shore. That's funny, right? I'm Encino Man. Was there a reason to go with Cocoa City instead of Game Maker? Yeah, for me, the big advantage was I'm already familiar with Cocoa Studio X, so that's huge, right? Because that saved me 3 to 6 months, I would imagine, just going with the game engine that I already knew. To me, the biggest advantage of using Cocoa Studio X is that I can publish cross-platform. So once I've written my code once in C++, I could publish to all those platforms, Windows, Mac, Linux, iOS, Android, all those. So that's a big advantage to me, cross-platform, and it's open source. If I were a beginner just starting out, though, I would think about using GameMaker because it's just great for starting out. yeah, I think this is it. Totally. Yeah, this is the one. Totally. You found it, Vlad. This is the article I was thinking of right here. Motion blur in Street Fighter 3. Okay. So it wasn't Street Fighter 2. Yep, this is it. How was the Steam Greenlight process? It was really easy, actually. Because I was doing my Kickstarter at the same time, it got greenlit in like 10 days. And I do have a lot of my stats up on my TIG source. TIG source. I've lost my link. What? It's like, it's on here somewhere. I have one of these pages. I'm sorry, I'm not going to go into all those pages, but I did post a lot of my green light stats right there. So maybe that helps you out. But yeah, doing it with, if you do your Steam Greenlight with a Kickstarter, you're getting a huge influx of backers that are also going to, because backers are some of the coolest people on the internet. They'll help you with just about anything, because backers are people that are willing and they're so stoked about whatever you're creating that they will pay you before you even have created that thing fully. So backers are rad people. They're forward-looking people, and they will do stuff to help you out. All you got to do is ask them. All you got to do is keep on being a cool person and just ask for help and be willing to accept help. So that's what's so great about doing a Kickstarter with the Greenlight process, is that you can get so much help. You can get through that process so fast. So Songbringer got like through in like 10 days. But then after I did the Greenlight process, I realized that there's a lot of advantages to even to having a long, long drawn out Greenlight process, because I was doing a live stream and we were talking about the stats and stuff like that. And there's a few other developers that got on here and they were talking about their stats on Greenlight, right? And when we looked at the ones that were on Greenlight for a long, long time, they had overall a lot more people that actually came through and got to be aware of their game. So it really doesn't matter whether you get through Greenlight fast or whether it takes you a long time, because either way, it's an advantage. On one hand, you're going to get more people that actually follow your game. On the other hand, you're just through it really fast and you're already guaranteed that you're coming out on, not guaranteed, but you already got that Greenlight approval, so you know you can come out on Steam. That's a crazy one. Well, let's see how it looks in the animation. How can you actually fail Kickstarter this if you don't get your funding? Yes, you are the one setting the amount you need. So I highly recommend, you've got to have a following before you do the Kickstarter. You've got to have people that are stoked to play your game, that are already to give you money for that game, you know? So so you've got to have enough of a following that it's going, that you feel like you can succeed with it. Why don't people simply just set a small amount so they're sure they get it? They do that a lot. I've seen that technique a lot, and I don't recommend doing it myself because I think it looks weird, and I don't think you're being honest with yourself. And also, if you win a Kickstarter where you set a super low goal, like if you set your goal to $1,000, and I've seen this a lot, I don't recommend it because you don't actually know whether you've gained a much of a following through that. So what I'm trying to say is, if you win your Kickstarter and you set your goal to only $1,000, first of all, maybe you don't actually have enough funds to do it, which in essence you're lying to yourself and you're lying to all those people. I think it's a very bad thing. And secondly, you don't actually know whether you truly are getting that following. You know what I mean? Like, you don't know whether your game has potential unless you're honest with yourself with how much you think you need, and if you hit that goal, that's a really good sign that you have a good game on your hands. You've created great art, you've created a great gameplay or great video, whatever it is, you've got a good thing on your hands. So I hope that makes sense there. A lot of this I'll explain in the post I'm writing, which I'm about halfway done. Cool. This looks like some homework for tonight. Okay, let's do this, and we'll check this baby out in the game. That's kind of like too much lightning there, but oh well, we'll see. It's only going to be one frame, so. Was it random? What do you mean by random? No, oh, you mean the goal of 9,000? No, it's not random at all. If you read my page, read down to the bottom where I was at, I talk about how much I need. That I figured out all my expenses, and this was actually too low. Now I'm at the point where my Kickstarter funds are going to run out a little bit too soon. They're going to run out in December, and I would love it if I could keep developing this game till March. Like, that would be ideal, but I'm probably gonna have to kind of push it out sooner. So I figured I need about $1,500 a month, and I figured I needed about 6 months to finish the game, which was also an underestimating, right? So you multiply that by six, and that gives you $9,000. But really, I should have asked for more like 9 to 12 months at more like $1,600 a month or $1,700 a month. That would have been more honest. I just tried to keep it as low as I possibly thought I could squeak by on, because I thought I wanted to be able to hit the goal. I was afraid that I wouldn't hit the goal. But had I set a higher goal, I think I would have hit it anyways. You notice that on Kickstarter, it's like people get what goals they think they can't. People tend to get around what they ask for. It's weird. So if you ask for more and you really believe you can hit it, I think you will. Oh, homework! Yeah, we were joking the other day on the stream about how I always drop URLs up here, and they're like, it's homework. You have to do it later. And it's true. Later on tonight, I'll go and look at these videos. What does the money go for? It's just for my monthly expenses. And in fact, it's gonna run out too soon. Like, you know, and also what I was trying to say there was that. On the Kickstarter, it says I got $15,000, right? But really, $2,000 of that, no, more like $2,200 of that, was fraudulent backers. So like $2,200 was fraudulent backers, so I didn't get that. Even though it says my project got $15,000, I really only got $12,800. And then you take out Kickstarter's fees and stuff like that, and also like the fees, that takes it down to like 11,500. And then you take out my expenses of fulfilling the posters, and that comes to be more like $11,000. So there you go. It really turned out to be more like $11,000. And so that means even though I thought I could get by with $9,000, basically this money is going to run out in December, and this $11,000, even though it says $15,000, it really turned out to be more like my original goal. That's all I'm trying to say. So kind of on Kickstarter, you got to be honest with yourself, and you got to, like, I think set your goal a little higher than you think if you're the kind of person that's like me, where you're idealistic about everything. Nice. Yeah. No, really, I do my homework. It's funny, but I'm one of those guys that does stuff. I do my homework. Yeah. Not even Shia could do anything about it. About the homework. Okay. We got four frames. Let's set these up. Kickstarter gets about 5%, and then Amazon Payments, who they use for the payments, also gets about 5%. So that's about 10% will go towards that. What's up, Sean? It's crazy. But the good news about your Kickstarter fees and your Amazon payments is that That's only that's actually based on the total that you actually get. So even though, like, whatever your project says it gets, after they take out the fraudulent backers and things like that, or people that just end up not paying, you know what I mean? That's what they base that 10% off of. So you're not going to have to worry about that part. Sean is crazy. What's up, man? Yeah, I can, but I don't have enough people to watch my Twitch to get ads and to get. You have to be a Twitch thingy. You have to get like to be a Twitch partner or something like that, and you have to have a ton of followers and daily people watching your stream to be able to get to be a Twitch partner. So yeah. Basically, I hope that I can sell some pre-orders of this game, and I think the pre-orders will pick up a little bit when it gets closer to being finished. So I hope that I can get enough pre-orders to get me by until March, because I'd really ideally like to release this in March, because I think I can get more done that way and just release a better product to start with. Yeah, Toby Peters, yeah, you got to think about income tax too. So yeah, there's a lot to be realistic about when it comes to Kickstarter, your goal on Kickstarter. You should pretty much just increase it if you're an idealist. So rule of thumb, it's probably more than you think you need. Aim high, I guess. All right, we got it. We got some lightning. Lightning 0 through 3. Cool. I know, TimesCar, right? That's a Twitch problem. There's a fix for that. If you get Nightbot or one of those bots, it just fixes all your colors for you. Thanks, Vlad. Where am I based? I'm in Oakland, California. So pretty much California. Okay, so right, we're into creating the lightning sword. The lightning sword. Let's switch the player to using the lightning sword to start with. And then we'll start this code. And I'm gonna put down my graphics tablet, switch to mouse mode so I can code faster.
I'm thirsty.
Thanks, BMC. Yeah, I appreciate it. Everybody that pre-orders and everybody that backed, that's one great thing about Kickstarter is it will fill you with so much confidence to launch a successful Kickstarter campaign, and you'll get so many followers for your game. You get through green light fast. Like, it's a great thing to do a successful Kickstarter. So just prepare well. No, don't be intimidated. Just start small. If you don't understand code that much, start with what you do understand and build from there. In fact, if you're using an engine like GameMaker or Unity, a lot of the things that I do, you don't even have to do. You know, 'cause I do a lot of my stuff with code, with GameMaker and Unity, you do a lot of stuff with software. It's just like clicking things and linking things together that you create a game, kind of. So, okay, we're using the lightning sword. Let's, I got where we should start. We need to get this lightning sword. When it launches, it needs to have the lightning effect. Let's get to an area where these guys aren't. These guys are kind of annoying to fight because they take forever to get on the screen. Now here's some guys that are already on the screen. This will work. This is a pretty cool area to fight on anyways. Okay, so we'll save there. Do I use version control? Totally, man. Git. Oh, sweet, Grim Gary. Well, there's the best way to do it is on songbringer.com. Yeah. That way you get it on a Humble Bundle. So like basically songbringer.com, you click pre-order and you can choose your level that you want to contribute at. The $16 version gets you the game when it comes out and your honorary backer status, so your name gets in the credits and all that. And the album, the digital album. So and then there's the $32 level if you want like beta access, and then $64 level gives you earlier beta access. So if you want to do that, that's where you do that. And then what's great about doing it on here is that you own it on Humble Bundle, so it's all tracked there and you're all good to go. You don't have to worry about it. So No way. I guarantee you Azenris understands 100%. How many commits? How do I check that? How do I check how many commits? I have no idea. If anybody has a quick solution for that, let me know. Yeah, that's a great movie. Release day shirts. Yay. Yes, Alien, there's already controller support. I've got controller support, and I tested with two different kind of controllers, so I've got a cool like Super Nintendo style controller, but I also guaranteed I got it working on Xbox controllers too. It's built into the game, so you don't have to worry about using some kind of janky solution or whatever. So it's all good. When you start the game, you can actually bind all your keys yourself. Thank you. Nice one. 572. Nice. I'm gonna keep that command for later. So if I want to see how many git commits I'm at. Nice one. So I would do make GC. Cool. Wow. 572 commits. Sean is crazy. Yeah, you'll get a Steam key. If you do Humble Bundle, you get both the DRM free version and the Steam key. And I'll do vice versa too. If anybody wants to convert their Steam key into a DRM free version, I'll honor that too. Oh, here's another one. Get rev list head count. Oh, that's a good one too. That's quicker. Like it. Is the stream dead? I don't think it is. Let's see. Looks like it's okay. Yeah, there definitely should be. The modem's okay. The modem is okay. The band's gonna make it. Okay, here's what I was talking about. When it launches a lightning sword. We need collision type of lightning. So let me get that constant set up. All right, cool. We got lightning finally. I'm not sure what the fourth element will be. Maybe wind. Wind would be cool. I'm trying not to do too many elements to start with because I need to haul ass and make this game as fast as possible. So maybe this will be like a thing I'll add later, like a wind sword. And yeah, anything I add to the game will be free updates. So I don't plan on having any downloadable content. I don't have any plans for in-app purchases on the iOS version or whatever. It's just going to be all free updates. 0, 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 12, 13, 14. Lightning, 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 lightning. Cool. Fart sword. Pizza sword. Is the MacBook Pro good enough for game dev? What are you talking about, Uni? Are you talking about Unity or are you talking about University? I think you mean University, but yeah, I would say either way, MacBook Pro is rad. It's got solid state drive. You know, mine's got a 256 gig solid state drive, which is one of the dopest things ever. Oh, lightning. Thanks for following. Whoa, right on. Yeah, I haven't seen The Witness yet. Check it out. Actually, let's check out The Witness while it's compiling. I think I saw some GIFs for this once. This looks great. I didn't know Jonathan Blow was doing this one. That's great. Yeah, I'm on a MacBook Pro. It's a 2013 model, so it's kind of old, but it's a great computer. When I first got it, it was just so blazing fast compared to everything else. But then, of course, if you have a Mac Pro, Mac Pros are just the rad. Oh, you know what? No, I haven't seen this game. Sorry, I might be slowing down the stream by doing these YouTube videos right now. Yeah, I'm standing. Yeah, better for my back, my spine. What's up, puppy? Oh, really? Oh. Well, cool. That's a good thing to know. Maybe I do have a rad one. Okay, cool. So now we're attaching the lightning attribute to the ghost sword when it launches. So now when we go to health system, when it actually hits an enemy, I want to create this lightning. So create lightning entity. This is going to be a lot like this. So if changer dot collision dot flags and collision lightning and e dot collision dot, and not e dot collision dot flags dot lightning immune, then we're going to create some lightning. So we need to create an entity for this lightning. It's going to be like do its animation. We'll do a white effect and we'll leave a black mark on the ground. So to start with, we need an entity that's just going to animate this lightning effect. Okay. We're going to create an entity. Give it a position of E. Wait, this is right where we're hurting. Yeah, we want to get right where this guy is currently. Now you have eat up position. Now pause. New. Do we need a collision? No, we don't even need a collision component. That's cool. Okay, we just want a render component though. Render component with profile parent Z. Okay, let's do a lightning profile. Okay, sounds loop. Well, we don't need a sound just yet. Just need this idle animation frame count. There's four of them. It's probably gonna be faster like that, and it's just called lightning. Okay, we got that. And now we can go to system. Use this profile. Parent is gonna be area layer address of Z one that gives an automatic Z. I'm not sure if it'll be animated. So, all right, man. Good night. Yeah, have a good sunrise. Hey, yo, what's up, Spyware? What projects did I work on before this? You can check out wizardfoo.com. It's got all kind of my previous history and stuff, but wizardfoo.com/games. My most recent game besides Songbringer is Hero Bash. And this is an iOS MOBA. I made this game with my buddy. He did the art. He did the game design. I did the programming and the sound. And it took us a year and a half. We didn't market it very well. We didn't market it at all until at the very end, we spent $5,000 marketing it. And to this day, the game makes about $20 a month. So the lesson learned there is market your game from day one, especially if you're an indie. Don't rely on just money to do your marketing for you. You've really got to build a following from day one and just like post images on Twitter, do live streams like this. Do something to share your game every day. I don't know if that'll run this idle animation, but anyways, I'm gonna do system and F. ID. Okay, f.render.sprite. Run action. So we'll schedule an action to run. So schedule once. So what really all I'm doing here is just I want this lightning to go. We'll see it really quick, and then it'll be gone really fast too. So I just want to delete the entity. And I'm thinking, let's do like a half second to start with. That's probably gonna be too long. We'll go world area delete entity ID. Actually, this isn't even a part of the world. So it would be something like this, actually. Wait. Oh, wow. All right, PMC. Later. This could be better. It's like this. All we need to do is schedule that and then do this to delete it all. So then I can use this method without having to think about its interior design or whatever. Okay, so all I want to see is some lightning and then for it to be removed. I'm not sure if this will actually animate it first, because I think there's a problem where it doesn't run the idle to start with, but let's see. Oh, still got the fire sword. Okay, what's up with that? I thought I turned on the... Okay, we got lightning. What? What happened to fire? Fire zero. What did I do? Where did I go wrong? Let's see. Okay, let's see, first of all, if the player has the lightning sword. Yeah, okay, we got the lightning sword. It must be, okay, we got changer, collision flags, lightning. It must be here where it launches the sword. Oh. Wait, no. Oh, yeah. I just copy pasted some code. No reason. No wonder. Okay, so there we go. We got lightning flag there. That should fix that to start with. So I don't know how this will look. It might not even animate. It might not even, it's not gonna spark. And I don't even know if it'll delete it, but see if this is a good start. Oh, sweet. Nice. Oh, it's better than I thought it would be. Yeah. Oh. Okay, let's get it to animate. Yeah. What's up, the lag script? So we want to go f.render.setAnimationIdleForever. And we'll see if this works good. And then I want to do some kind of flash. And I want to leave a black mark on the ground. Hey, what's up, Lith? Welcome to stream. Sorry, it's about to be done. In a second here, I almost got the lightning working though. Oh, it's still not animated. Huh, why isn't it animating? Will the lightning move smoothly from the sky to the ground? Do you know that lightning actually moves from the ground up to the sky? But it happens so fast it doesn't look like that. Like it hits from the ground, from the sky. No, it won't actually do that. That's, I only have a tenth of a second or whatever to do this, so it's going to be a little faster than that. I'm just going to draw it like that. But I don't know. Maybe I could play around with that. Maybe to get it to look better. Oh, yeah.
Sorry, guys.
What's up, Ali Lazo? Yes, Cocos is a great coding program. You got to be experienced though to use it. It's a great engine, really is. It's cross-platform, open source. We've talked about this already on this video a couple times though. It really, I think it does. I'm pretty sure that's correct. I watched some nature show and they were telling me that. Okay, why is it not animating? Oh, it needs a profile component. Duh. Okay, new profile component. Lightning. Yeah. Okay, so what I'm doing here today is creating the lightning sword. Oh, I want to color this. I want to do a flash. I want to do some like, yeah, there we go. Now it's looking cooler. But it needs to be shorter. Yeah, it needs a little less time. So we're talking maybe a third of a second. And I want to do the delay per frame to be like really, really short. This is like maybe even half about of that. That'd be crazy. Might as well color this too. So let's get the color. Auto color equals gear. Okay, let's see what that did. That might have been it too fast, actually. I think it was actually felt too fast to me. Let's go with the little 0.05 next time. So color equals gear component, get item color for K item ghost sword lightning. That'll give that color. And we can use it here in render component. Respiration? Hey, what's up, Pierre? Hello. Welcome to the stream. I'm just about done with the stream today. This is Sunday for me. I'm about to just chill with my girl, relax, get some dinner. So, yeah, but this is almost working. I almost got this. I mean, it works, but I need to. It's almost looking better. You know, what it'll be now is kind of refining it, making it look better and better and better. So that color was a bit too. You know what? It's like a bit too wide too. The whole bolt. Let's start with making this color a little bit less saturated. Color HSV desaturate. All right. Good night, Vlad. Enjoy, man. Thanks for stopping by. This is kind of janky to do this way, but I'm going to actually change the sprite's width. Or its scale on the X to be about half, because I think that's about where I want it to be. And then I'll actually go and change that in the actual file here. Like I'll go and I'll change the actual width of this lightning to be better, but I didn't realize it would be so big and wide. And also I like to randomly flip it. So f.render.sprite.setflippedX if drand f01 is less than a half. And I also want to do a I want to do a bright flash of light. Oh, I know, right? Yeah, the Easter egg name. Totally. I'm glad you suggested that. That's a cool Easter egg. You guys will know it's there, right? And it'll be a total like lore thing about this game. Okay, so let's create a layer of color. Auto ref layer equals kit layer color. Area layer is the parent. Color 4B white. Or we can do a color 4B and then color.r. Nice. Cool, Pierre. Welcome, man. Welcome to the stream. If you're just getting here, there's all of my videos for making this game from the very first day of making this game are all on YouTube if you want to watch those too. So if you're interested in game development, you want to see this game from the beginning, it's all there. Z, this is going to be on top of like everything, so we'll do 9999. And we'll run an action really quick to just delete it really fast. So layer dot dot run action sequence. Should I do sequence? Sequences. Either way you want to, I could do this either way. Oh, cool. I didn't know they did have that. So I'll delay time, create. So I'm thinking of maybe a tenth of a second you see this bright light. Actually, maybe less than a tenth of a second. Maybe only 0.05 or something. And then it just removes itself. So there, we're going to have a flash of light. Yes, yeah, exactly. Yeah. I can't play music because YouTube flags my videos if I have music in them. And I've tried it a few times and I thought I could get away with it a couple times, but nope. Their freaking algorithm is so good. It detects music. Even if I played music on my phone, which is not on my computer, it recognized that. It was like, oh, nice. So I'm thinking a little bit faster of a flash. Yeah, I know, right? Yeah, come on, YouTube. Seriously. We're not trying to like steal people's music and stuff. We just want to listen to music while we're doing a 2-hour video, you know? Yeah. Yeah, so I'm thinking maybe the smallest delay time we can get, and it removes itself. Yeah, it's looking better. Every bit's making it look a little bit better. I still think it's maybe a little too wide or something. Oh, it lights up my face? That's funny. There we go. So that's the fastest light we can get. Okay, I got an idea. Let's try. Yes, seizure warning. Sorry. Yeah, there's Java that learn code the hard way. Oh, no, there's not. Never mind. I don't know. I don't know Java myself. I wish I could help you with that. There's probably a great tutorial out around there somewhere, though. Okay, to try and make this a little less of a seizure warning and a little bit better looking, I'm gonna try making this layer with an additive lighting. See how that looks. And if anybody does have seizure issues, don't watch this. There you go. Okay, let's try it with a little more opacity. Layer.set opacity 128. That's gonna be half the opacity, so it'll just, hopefully that will make it look like everything's really lit up really a lot, but it's not just completely white. Yeah, that's better, right? It's a little bit less intense, but it's still really bright. Okay, what would it look like if it were really, like, even half that? So 64 is going to be 25% opacity. I liked it a little bit higher, more like 128 or so. Yeah, it is definitely way better, right? Maybe, I think 80 is, what's the fire ratio squared times 255? 97. Let's do 97. Yeah, totally. Cool, Nano. Thanks, man. I think eventually I probably will. I'll go kind of like redo some things about it and start over with it and kind of like market it from day one. But yeah, it's a good game, right? I think it's a pretty good game. It has a lot of potential. It just needs more players, you know, which could be attracted with some more competitive elements. One thing we wanted to add to it was tournaments. So there'd be like weekly tournaments. Nice. That's looking better. Okay, but I do gotta get going. I've ran out of steam for development today. It's been a long video already, so we're at 2 hours and 15 minutes. So yeah, so that's gonna be it for today's stream. Once again, if you guys are just joining this video, this game is called Songbringer. It's a Zelda-like game, like it's a lot like Zelda 1. But it's procedurally generated, so you get to create a different world every time, or you can create the same world you want to if you enter the same code each time. So, there's items, there's lots of fun stuff already in this game, there's dungeons, there's a big overworld, and if you're interested in the game and you like it, you can pre-order the game at songbringer.com, and that gets you your name in the credits and on the main menu of the game. So that's a cool way to forever emblazon your name in the credits of a game, because it's straight up right on the main menu. So so that's it for today's stream, and I'll be back tomorrow. I stream just about every day, usually around 4 o'clock Pacific time. So, but the best way to catch the live stream is to follow, because I change my time every day. So, appreciate you, everybody.